Welcome to the testing world. Now I'm going to cover one of the very important concept, which is setup and the teardown. First of all, we need to understand what is setup and the teardown. We are going to write many test cases in robot framework. If you want to perform any task before the test case, like before the test case, I want to start browser and enter URL and maximize window. So any task which you want to perform before the test case, I'll put into the setup. And whatever the task you want to perform after the test case, I'll put into the teardown. So means if we have any prerequisite which need to be executed before the test case, that will be in the setup. And whatever the task that we want to be executed after your test case is completed, I'll put into the teardown. I'll show you how we can use it in our automation. So I'm just coming here. First of all, I'm going to create some user-defined keywords. So here I'm going to create new keywords. I'm just coming to the resources. First keyword is start browser and maximize. So I'm giving the user-defined keyword like start browser and maximize. Okay, what you want to do in this? So I want to open browser. That's my keyword, which is existing keyword. And again, after two spaces, I want to give URL. So http www.thetestingworld.com. That's my URL. After two spaces, I am putting Chrome, like I want to start on the Chrome. Now, so I want to maximize browser window. So maximize browser window. Now that's one keyword, or I'll say user defined keyword I have created. Next, I want to do close browser, want to close browser window. So for that, I want to do two tasks. First, I want to display title of the page in the logs and then close browser. So I'm just displaying like, okay, first of all, I want to pick title. So for that, title is equal to, we have seen how we can pick value. So get title is the keyword which is going to pick title of the currently opened page and going to store in this title variable. Next, I'm going to do is log. After two spaces, I want to log this title. And at the end, I want to close browser. So now we have seen, I have created two user-defined keywords, one starting browser and one is closing browser. Now I'm coming to the test case. In the test case, I'm going to write the test case from the scratch, from the start. So first of all, my test case would be do registration of this page, on this page. So I'm going to write 3-4 steps, like I want to enter username. So I'm writing like input text and name colon what you want to use. So I'm using this locator. We have seen how we can go for the locator and all. And after two spaces, I want to enter testing in this. Then I'm coming input text and I want to enter email, so I'm locating that and name is this, so we can use name or any other option which you want to use. I'm saying name colon and after two spaces like testing word India @gmail.com. That's my email. Okay, now I want to enter password. So I'm just writing 3 lines in this test case. Enter username, password and email. So input text name colon this and password I want to give 123456. You can give any password. Now as of now we have only one test case. Now I want to execute this, but before execution this test case, I want my browser need to be started and it should be maximized. For that, I'm not writing my own code. I'm just going here and I'm saying setup. in setup which keyword you want to call. So I want to call a keyword with the name start browser and maximize. I just copied that, and after two spaces, that's the keyword which I want to start as a setup. Then tear down means after the execution, what you want to execute. After the execution, I want to execute this user defined keyword. I've just copied and pasted here. So whatever the task you want to perform before execution of test case, that will be setup. After execution of the test case, that is tear down. As of now, I have added setup and the tear down on the test case level. Everything is okay. Just clearing screen, running it. So if browser started means my setup is executing. So browser started and maximize. One mistake that I have done is it is going to be failed because my URL should be /testings. Then we are going to get that registration form. So it was an incorrect URL. I have just corrected that and executing again. Now setup is executing, which is starting the browser and going to maximize it. Then it enter whatever the task, it will perform whatever the task you want to do. And after that it closed the browser. So my setup and tear down executed successfully. If you see the report, so I'm just coming to the report, refresh. So in the report it shows that's your test case, but in the test case we have that is a setup and that's a tear down. So it shows the logical order in which all that complete test case is executed. First setup, then all the keywords, and at the end tear down. We have added setup and the tear down on the test case level. Now I take an example. I have one more test case, robot next test case. That's the second test case name. In this test case I want to click on this radio button, so I just trying to locate that. And that's a name. I am going to use name. Hope you remember, we have like select radio button, and I want to use name colon this. And hope you remember, here we find out the group and the value. So group is this, two spaces, value is office. I want to select office. But again, before this test case, you want to start your browser and maximize. And after the test case, you want to close the browser. So I'm just coming here and adding the setup again, like setup. And that's the keyword. Tear down, same keyword. If I execute it now, so let me show you. I just clear screen, executing. So now we have two test cases in that file, in the test suite file. So both the test cases will be executed, and before each test case it's going to execute setup, and after each test case is going to execute tear down. So first test case, now it's executing second test case. So before each test case it's a setup, and after each test case it's tear down. Everything is executed successfully. I'll show you the report here. That is two test cases, and that's the first test case, so setup and tear down. In the second test case it's setup and tear down. Now if you think your setup and tear down is common in all the test cases of this test suite file, so rather than defining the setup and tear down on the test case level, I'm just coming here and removing the setup and tear down. Rather than defining setup and tear down on the test case level, I can go in the settings and we have option of test setup. Which keyword you want to call? So I want to call a keyword like this. So I'm defining on the test suite level, means test setup and test teardown. And this time I want to call this keyword. Now we have a setup and the teardown on the test suite level, which will be applied on all the test cases of this test suite. Means now we are not writing into the individual test case. That will be applicable to all test cases of this file, or I'll say test suite. So now we have placed it on setting area on one place and it will be executed with all test cases. I'm just going to execute. So now two test cases will execute, and before each test case it will start browser, maximize window, and after test case it will close browser. So let's see that. So first browser started, first test case is executing, done, browser's closed. Now second test case started, browser started for the second test case, maximize, do the task and close window. And if I show you report, it will be almost same as it was doing before. So first test case, that setup and teardown, even we did not added setup and teardown on the test case level, that is on the suite level, and that is for the second test case. So we have seen what is the use of setup and teardown and what all the levels we can add it. It could be on the test case level or test suite level. So here in this session we have seen what do you mean by the setup and teardown and how we can add it on the test case and test suite level. That's all we have for this session. Thanks for watching this video.